This old Pentium 3 laptop is equipped with a 30GB hard drive. I'd like to put an SSD in it, but IDE SSDs are very expensive. There's a cheaper solution though. Stay with me to find out. It's the I bought this 265GB SSD from Verbatim. Let's take it out of the box. This is the whole thing. Obviously, this won't directly fit into a Pentium 3 laptop. That's where this comes in. It's a laptop IDE housing with a B-key M.2 slot I bought on AliExpress for under 10 euros. Let's put it together. The SSD in the adapter and a screw to hold it in place. Put the cover on and fasten it with some insanely tiny screws. Why? There we have it. Our own IDE SSD for a fraction of the price of a fully assembled one. Let's take that old 30GB drive out of the laptop. It's inside of a cage, so I'll take it out and put the SSD in here. The screws are hard to get in as screw holes in this plastic cover aren't threaded. Once in, they're fine though. Can't get it all the way in. Looks the same. I finally got it so that it would stay in place, but the system didn't detect a drive. So I tested it on a PC with an adapter from 44-pin laptop IDE to full-size IDE, and it seems to work fine. Holding them on top of each other, I can see the adapter is slightly misaligned. So instead of using the original cage, I put a screw in the drive and put a twist tie on it so I could put it inside of the laptop and have something to pull it out when needed. I booted FreeDOS and had it partition the disk, which went well. But as you can see, it only utilizes around 130GB. That was to be expected, because that's the 28-bit LBA limit on all the systems. Note that some systems just plainly won't boot with a disk that's too big. The solution for that is to disable auto detection and enter a lower size into the system's BIOS. So, did I buy 265GB just to throw away almost half of it? Of course not. The magic words are dynamic drive overlay. Dynamic drive overlay software sits into the drive's boot sector and overrules whatever size the BIOS is reporting, so an OS can use all of the drive's capacity. For this, I wrote an old version of Untrack's disk manager to a floppy. Four 64GB partitions seems like a good idea since I'm planning on multi-booting. So this is what it looks like after installation. You don't directly boot from floppy or CD-ROM, but load the disk overlay from the hard drive first. Press C to boot from CD. There we go, let's install. Alright, so the full installation took about 15 minutes. I don't think I'll be able to match that on the original hard drive. To be honest, I have no idea if this actually works with anything else than DOS or Windows, so let's try that. I'd like to try MCN Live, a very old live distro built upon a 2007 Mandriva release. I was one of the people helping to write scripts and stuff for it, so there's some nostalgia here. Here's the awesome KDE 3.5 desktop. Let's just try to install. Oh, that doesn't look good. Let's pick the second half of the disk, see how that goes. Yeah. Yeah, I was afraid that might happen. It seems that the overlay got overwritten here. I tried to restore that, but to no avail. When searching for this issue, I found this thread on Vogons.org, where a commenter says that OnTrack Disk Manager has issues in modern Windows. They haven't tried Linux, but this might be our very problem. They recommend using Easy Drive 9.06W instead. So I tried that, but Easy Drive only saw half of the drive. Not too useful. So instead I rebuilt my drive with OnTrack Disk Manager and just installed Windows 98 and 2000. To be honest, I think I might be better off buying a smaller SSD for this machine, as this solution isn't working too well for me. If anyone knows a better and or more modern solution for this, I'd be happy to learn from you. When just using DOS and old versions of Windows though, this works great. Booting Windows 98 is quite a bit faster, although of course still limited by the IDE bus. Windows 2000 doesn't seem to boot that fast though. I don't have footage on booting this from the old hard drive, so you'll have to take my word for that. Both operating systems feel a lot more snappy though. Was there an elephant in the room? Oh yeah, trim support. That's absent from these old operating systems. I tried this DOS tool I found on the Internet Archive, but after using it my Windows 98 registry got corrupted and I had to reinstall all drivers. Use with caution, I'd say. If anyone knows a better solution, please enlighten us all. Not having trim support isn't a huge risk though. But the SSD doesn't know which sectors are empty and thus might slow down over time. That's all I have for you today. If you like this video, do the like and subscribe dance and don't forget to slam that bell for another round. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time. Oh, I'd almost forget. I recently started a Discord server. If you'd like to connect with me and other nerds, feel free to do so. The invite link is in the description of this video.